Thank you. Thank you. You know it's rude to enter without knocking. The youth of today. No manners at all.
Though we neglected to knock, we did create something of a commotion. I had hoped that would suffice.
Heavy-handed as ever, I see. And still not a hint of grace. Some things never change.
To give credit where credit is due, I learned from the best. It has been too long, Master Matoya.
Indeed it has. Oh, it's good to see you again, my girl. And with your fiery spirit unquenched. But look at you, all grown up and womanly. The one there in the fancy duds, that's Louis Soir's granddaughter, I take it?
Grandson, begging your pardons. You knew my grandfather, my lady.
Knew him? Ha! We were constantly at each other's throats, like rabid dogs we were. Oh, he was a stubborn bugger, was your grandfather. Never a dull moment when he was around, though, I'll give him that. As for you, boy, I've known you since you were a rosy-cheeked babe at the teat.
And my sister too, I gather. May I say what an honor it is to meet you again, my lady?
Spare me the hollow pleasantries, boy. I'll wager my remaining good teeth you didn't come to a forgotten corner of Eorzea to flirt with a wrinkly old woman. Now, out with it. What is it you need of me? Azizla. I never thought I'd hear that name again.
You are familiar with it.
As familiar as one can get from poring over musty old tomes. The Alagon set the isle afloat not long before the sun set on their empire. Old Louis Soir and I often talked about it. The place is home to a research facility dedicated to finding ways of mastering mighty beings, such as primals and dragons. And find ways it did too. Frightening ones. Such secrets as lie buried on Azizla aren't fit to see the light of day. And now you tell me a band of dragon-beating primal botherers are trying to dig them up?
Indeed. And to make matters worse, the Ascians have a hand in their plot. They must be stopped, no matter the cost.
I see. Very well.
You will help us then? Truly? I had not anticipated such an impassioned response. Could it be that the presence of young blood has stirred your own?
Ah, some things never change. One day that pertness is going to cost you your tail, my girl. Don't say I didn't warn you. 'Twas some 50 years ago, shortly after Garlemald had brought all of Ilsebard under its rule. Faced with a threat of invasion, the people of Sharlayan scrambled about for a means to resist the Empire. For my part, I was tasked with developing an etheric converger.
Ah, yes. A device which draws in ether and concentrates it to produce a destructive force.
But as my research neared its end, it was denounced by the Forum, who claimed that my device was more likely to destroy us than our enemies. After that, they and I had a little falling out, and I decided to seal away all the fruits of my research, lest the dunder-headed ingrates reap any benefit. Petty, I know, but gods, it was satisfying.
Do mine ears deceive? 'Twas you, was it not, who was so fond of saying that all knowledge exists to advance mankind, that how it is used depends on us?
I don't remember. Perhaps. All right, yes. It was a pet phrase of mine. And that should give you a notion of how sick and tired I was of those spineless wretches of the Forum. All talk and no trousers, that lot. That's why I decided to remain behind, rather than join the Exodus.
You may have had your disagreements with my grandfather, but upon that point, your minds were as one.
With respect, Master, the fruits of your research should not be left to spoil. Will you share with us the secrets of the etheric converger?
I will. All the information you need is contained in a tome I wrote on the subject. But you'll have to fetch it from the forbidden section of the Great Library.
Ah, you were not exaggerating when you said that you had sealed it away. Though the city is abandoned, the library's guardians are all but certain to remain. We must needs cut a path through them. Come, let us away.
Not so fast. You don't expect that you can just waltz on in now, do you?